Are you still searching for a quick and advanced tool to repair corrupt MDF and NDF SQL Server database? And you want to export those files into SQL Server database? We bring you the solution. SysTools SQL Recovery Software. You can repair both primary and secondary database using our software. SQL Recovery Software is a useful utility to recover triggers, views, rules, tables, functions, stored procedures, associated primary key, unique keys, data types, etc. Now let's check out the other features. You can export files into SQL Server database, or you can save as SQL Server compatible scripts. Provides option to save files with schema or both schema and data. Our software recovers different versions of SQL Server database files. Also recovers data from wallet ransomware affected MDF files. Now let's install and run the software. In the home screen, there are advanced options. You can click on open button on top to open MDF file. Now select the desired MDF file and click open. A small window appears with further options. In the scan mode options, you can see the quick scan option and the advanced scan option. Below you can see select version checkbox selected by default. You can uncheck this option if you know the version, and you can choose the correct version from the option below. Otherwise, check the auto detect option, and the software will auto detect the SQL Server file. Now let's select the NDF tab options. Below you can see two radio button options. First is the auto detect option, and next option lets you choose the NDF file manually from a desired location. Click add file button to add files, select the desired file, and click open. Also there is option to add folder. Select the folder from a desired location, and click OK. And you can choose the remove file button to remove already selected files. Now in this example, let's continue with the auto detect option to select NDF file. Let's go back to the scan options tab. After making the desired options, click OK button. Now you can see the scanning process. After the scanning completes, a small window appears with option to save the scanned file. Click yes to proceed. Select the folder location to save the files, and click save button. And click OK. Now on the left side of the screen, you can see the tables, views, stored procedures, etc. Now for example, let's select the tables to preview its records. After selecting the option, you can view further details on the right side of the screen. Also, you can view further details of views and stored procedures, etc. Now, for example, if you want to load any previously scanned files, select the Load button option from the top navigation menu, then select the .str file from the previously saved location and click Open. And click OK. Now let's check out how to export the files. Select the export button from the top navigation menu. Now you can see the export options window opens with further advanced options. You can choose the SQL Server database option to export the files into a server database. And select the next option in order to save the files into SQL Server compatible scripts. Now in our example, let's select the SQL Server database option to export the files. And in the database authentication section below, enter the server name in the respective field option. Then select the Windows authentication option in order to access your database. Then you have to select the destination database to export the files into. Create new database option is selected by default. Or you can select the export to existing database option, if you want to export the files into an existing database. Now let's select the Create New Database option in our example. In the field option below, enter a new database name. And below you can see the With Schema and Data option selected by default. This option lets you export schema as well as data for the table. There is also the With Only Schema option to choose. This option will create schema for the selected tables, views or procedures. Now after selecting the desired options, click on Export button to start exporting the files. A small window appears, and click Yes if you want to export the deleted records as well. Then you can see the file exporting process, and after the exporting process completes, click OK. Now click Yes to export the details to a CSV file. Select the folder and click OK. You have successfully exported the files into a new database. Click Exit button to close the application and click Yes. Now let's check out the output files. Open Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio on your system. You can see the Object Explorer window on the left. Then select the databases, and within the databases option, you can see the exported database folder. For example, you can click on the tables to preview its records. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Log on to the given product page for more details on purchasing the product. For any query, mail us to support@systoolsgroup.com. Thank you for watching.